That'll always be like the first frame is what it will give me for a thumbnail. My videos at home and my folders, whatever. How you doing? Good morning. Who knows? Maybe we might make this one public. Yeah. This is, I don't know who the artist is. I couldn't find that out. And I'm taking major liberties with it. It's antique. It's an antique night scene. We're looking at it right now together. And, main thing I want to point out to you, see where this is like here, you know? That's way too far over. I don't think that works at all. I'm going to be moving that right over here. And the moon over here. I don't know, I want more. I tried to push up the contrast in the water a bit too, but we're going to be just riffing. It's a riff on an unknown old timey artist with the old timey trees. And I have noticed that these old timey trees will definitely influence the tree I do. Yeah, the board's been prepped. I may do a little video with that technique. It's quick and requires no roller. Yeah. Well, I should tell you about it now. I mean, let's resume it. Oh, we don't want to be too zoomed in. Right, so basically, like I do the board prep with the transparent gesso, which is just transparent. So the color of this board is like, I'm going to show you. It's just MDF. I've had a bunch of these little boards around. And I'm using them for these minis. Little bit of raw umber, a little bit of black, a little bit of burnt sienna, and a paper towel. Then it's toned. Then I sand it. You can see that edge there. That's what's up. Gives you sort of an interesting, you can tone things very quickly then without the roller cleanup. You know, I can squeeze out little bits of paint and the figures I've been doing, you know, different colors, you know. Anyway, that's what's up with that. So we're going to jump in and get going. One sec here. Okay, we're back. I could have done this without you, but hey, we'll do it with you. That is just some black with this fake raw umber from Rembrandt, which is great because it's still not dry on the palette. So that's something that annoys you. You can get the raw umber from Rembrandt, and it does, no, it's not a quick dryer. Board's quite dark. I was a little too dark, but so this probably just be members only. I'm on the cusp of doing a video for everyone again. As you can tell, alright, so what do we got here? 5. How's that? Look good? Alright. It's not really a straight, this other thing, and I don't know if you remember the reference, but I'm going to open this right up. classic compositions or it was interesting. Of course, I'm changing it, you know, but... Okay, so there's tree trunks. Off. If you have a tree plant, just has a tree hole there, maybe I'll put some little thing in there. But I'm not sure what that's buying me up there. So you can see why this is a riff, a riffin. See why he did that. He didn't make that totally straight. He put a little bit of a thank you. not gonna work. Too much going on back there. This one doesn't work much either. We gotta figure this out. I think we call that drawing stage done. In many ways, the riffing thing is way more liberating than the exact study thing. Taking inspiration, taking colors. I do similar things with my music, where I'll just grab chord progressions and tempos, and then everything else is what I'm coming up with, you know. Gives things a familiarity, but leaves room for originality as well. Okay, so I do think, I did want to open this up. I think I'm going to go a little further with it. Okay, let's do some color mixing. I'll lower that a bit for you. Can you see that? Yeah, you see it all right. Yeah, so I like these colors. And like I was saying before, it's a pretty dark board. Okay, we got gray. Probably won't be any blue. I'm thinking about it. Probably won't need to. Look how blue that really looks. Not very much though. What I like to do with my grays is I like to stagger them, so let's just pop you off the side, I don't need you quite that dark. By stagger them, I mean I want a middle gray, a warm gray. That's cool. This is, that's also what the artist has done. Great, I got a pretty good start this morning. I did a little painting this morning. And then this afternoon I gotta work at home doing it could be lighter. Should be. Could be, should be. Will be. There we go. Doing prints for this upcoming market. And then let's go super light. I don't know if I'll paint that moon in, probably not, but some clouds, we'll do something fun. We're riffing. Yeah, that is too long. That's a good thing about, so the way I'd like to break things down, I know I made it longer. I'm gonna open that up. Thank you. thinner. Yes, this is a bit long and skinny, but it's going to be subtle. I can't see it much, can you? You'll see it in a minute. So, there's a lesson for you there. I've talked about this before. You notice things, fix them. Don't assume you're going to remember later. Pretty much, if you have to, like, do what I did, interrupt my mixing here. Because every little interruption, too, gives your brain a chance to catch up. I'm going to go a little warmer on that. Too cool, cool and too warm. I don't know the wood. Alright, so we got some black. I don't think we need a ton of it. It's already pretty dark. And we're getting some greens. Let's get some of this left. I want to cool this off just a tiny. It'll have an impact. We need a lot more umber in that. Where's the real umber? Where are you? This tube's a little worse for wear. It's breaking up, breaking down. It takes a while to use, especially if you're working as small as I've been working for the last year or so. It just doesn't seem a good time to do broad, expansive things. Although, gosh knows, you know. So, reds is what's missing. There we go. I've still got a little more life than his green, but it doesn't have much green in here. We can almost just get away with the one green. Not a lot of color at all, so... I'm just going to put in some of that for the opacity of it. Dark to it'd be almost like the color of the board. I like that. Then I want to do a gray meets. Not on colorness, this is a nocturne, right? So you can see that's green, but that's brown. They're pretty close, but that's okay. So I'm always like, you know, at night when I get up. Go to the restroom there, so to speak. I was thinking about the colors, or step outside with the dog or whatever, yeah, and looking at how color shifts and changes. Back. Yeah, that was a 32. I'm missing 32. They usually use for church. Let's go light a little bit. All right, those are our colors. Let's zoom in. Get to painting. And we're back. Yarr. Glasses off. Starting in with the cool gray. Let's need some help. To mono, whatever. It's pretty dark too. That's some of that Rossi. I really like that color Rossi in it too. I like that raw sienna tone, but I don't have very much of it left. Got that Winsor Newton one, brown ochre. It'll do. It'll be alright. It's missing opacity, but it might be good then. I was pulling the opacity from the light. Bit more of a spread. Right. Rather than have like a defined moon, I've just got, obviously, there's going to be a moon there behind the clouds. Well, the sun's making an effort to come out, that's good. Lightly counterintuitive here. I'm going to do the reflection. Oh, that is not good. That's probably too dark. I'll find my way. That's a little bit of that, that fake. I see enough. three tubes of it. And I'm sitting here thinking, I don't want to get some of that gambling. But, like someone emailed me recently, I would look to buy some work, but I need to sell some paintings. Hey, here I am too. That's me too. I'd love to buy some paint, but I like sells, need to sell some paintings. Hopefully, we'll be doing that at the artisans market. Thought it would just be entertaining the peeps. Right. Alright, now we need a middle brush. We'll do the back first. I'll be leaning in these tinier brushes quite a bit. Looking good. Looking alright. It's getting crazy. Happy the sun come out. bit of a challenge here. We got such a narrow range, so getting some splits. You can see, I mean, you've seen the reference. The level of simplification is also a hook. Let's pop in some of these greens. Don't even look green, to be honest. We're gonna go a little lighter there. We're gonna bring in some cad yellow, which will help. And a little, I went so dark on that green that barely looks green. The patterns of the dorks is almost randomy, you know? I like that. This needs to be lighter. I'm gonna bring in some of this. Raw sienna. I haven't been showing you the palette much, but I haven't been doing much to change. just some red down here. Gonna differentiate it somehow. Gonna be still a little dark.
At least you found out now.
Oh no! How long? Fuck me! I hate that. All right, so I wasn't recording for a very long time. I don't know how long. It sucks, but we're not far from done, so. It is what it is. So I think what would be good now, I've been talking to myself for a while, I don't know how much I've painted without recording, a lot. So, not that much. I want to pop in some color, you know. And things here. Yeah, I know that wasn't good when I did it. We're getting close to the end because you start doing stuff like it'll be easy enough to fix, so. Yeah, I'd say that's done. Thing I do see though, I think I don't really need that line there, so it's not getting me much. I think I'm just gonna better. It's a leading. It's leading us somewhere, but where? I don't know. I don't want to go there. Anyway, take good care. Stay out of trouble. See you later. Oh, we'll do a little another zoom in.